Hey, it's John, Enduring Charm. Quick little video here to answer a question that comes up a lot about bathtubs or shower pans, same problem, and the lip of the shower pan when you're tiling. And you've seen in my videos before that I use a flashing system. I'll try to get a little closer here without tripping. Many of my videos you see I have this self-adhesive flashing that goes over the lip behind the backer board, and I also have plastic behind there too. So check out some of those other videos. So that's just my system. Some people don't do that. They don't have the flashing, but for me, it's just worked out well over the years. And it's not waterproofing. It's basically designed for the future if a homeowner does not maintain the caulk or the grout and there's a problem, there's some flashing there to keep the water out. That's all that's about. So the question comes, when you bring the backer board down to the tub or the shower pan, do you go to the lip or over the lip? And I've addressed this in a previous video. Very often you cannot bring it over the lip. And this is one example where you can't. If I back up here, so this backer board here goes up on this wall, and it's the same wall across the whole bathroom, okay? So if I tried to shim out that backer board, what would happen is I'd have a problem up here because, you know, one would not meet the other. So it's the same plane. I got to keep it the same plane. And because of that, because there's just no room in this alcove, I have to bring the backer board to the lip rather than over the lip. So the question that comes up in the comments is, now I have this space right here, which is in this case about an inch or an inch and an eighth high. And maybe it'll vary, but it's between an eighth of an inch and at most a half an inch deep. And what do you do with that space there? So what we're gonna do in this lip area, if the backer board has to come to the lip rather than over it, is to fill it with thinset. All right, we're gonna take our trowel here, you know, bring that thinset and fill that area and bring it flush to the backer board. Now, some people, when they're applying the tile, they'll put the thinset on the backer board and apply the tile to that. Some people prefer to back butter the tile itself and put it on a clean surface. And sometimes you do both. Like in this situation right now, I'm using a large format tile. So I'm actually putting thinset on the backer board and applying it, back buttering it on the tile and then smooshing the two together. So either way, you're gonna need to fill this area. So this tile right here is, you know, it's just a scrap, but it's a big tile. And I'm going to say, for the sake of argument, 6 inches and bigger, you don't really have a problem, because the thinset behind here is just going to provide support once it dries, so that if this area right here gets, you know, hit or banged or whatever, the tile's not going to crack. It just gives some support. The tile is adhered to the backer board up here, and because the tile, you know, is so big, most of it is adhered to the backer board, and there's just a tiny little section down here that is not adhered to anything, because the thin set is not going to adhere to the flashing. It's not going to adhere to, you know, the lip itself if you don't use the flashing. No matter what, the thin set's not going to adhere to anything here. So the point of it is only to provide support in the case it gets, you know, banged or hit this way. So a big tile, you're fine. But the question then becomes, if you use a small tile, I'll just use this piece as an example. If you had a small tile, very little of it would be adhered to the backer board, and a lot of it would be over this lip here. So that's a problem. So if you're using a small tile, let's say a subway tile or something like that, then you really must have the backer board come over the lip, not to the lip. Now, as we just pointed out, you can't always do that. Sometimes there's a situation where the room, you know, doesn't allow the backer board to come over the lip. In that case, you really shouldn't use a small tile, because this is not a good situation here. If you only have half the tile or less that's adhered to the backer board, there's a pretty good chance that down the line, this is eventually gonna work its way off and come loose. So not a good situation. So if you're using a small tile, you really must bring the backer board down over the lip. If you can't do that, you shouldn't use a small tile. If you have a large tile, I'm gonna say 6 inches or better, you're fine. There's so much area that's adhered to the backer board that this little section here won't matter. Okay, so I've used my trowel to fill this space here, and I've, you know, gone up to where the tile will be going. Now, as I said, I'm applying the thin set to the wall first, but I'm also back buttering the tile as well on both sides. All right, so there's the tile installed. You see this lip area is filled. I'm going over on this side, it's easier to see. This lip area is filled and the tile's installed. Now this area right here is gonna be a gap. There should be no thin set sticking out of there, and you're also not gonna grout that. You're gonna caulk that with a silicone caulk, because this tub will move at a different rate than the tile, and you want to be able to allow that to move, and the caulk will allow that to do that. If you try to grout that, it's gonna crack. So that's what it should look like, and I'm gonna move on down the line here.